All right, guys, this is gonna be my reaction. This is Cheaters Caught Red-Handed. It's about 9 minutes long. I guess it's from the Cheaters show. I remember that show, so let's take a look at it.
Coming up on this episode of Between Right There.
I want to wait till I hear those engines turn off.
Camera out of my face.
Who is in charge here?
Can you explain why you're taking this woman on a business trip?
I have to know the truth.
I'm doing the job.
Let's make this happen.
Oh, yeah.
I think I am
using
it. Hey,
Jimmy,
what's
Wow. That's a guy that got stabbed. I remember that guy. He got stabbed.
Misty, thank you for being with us this evening. Although I know the circumstances are not very pleasant for you, especially with what's been going on in your relationship. Are you ready to take a look at what our detectives have been able to do?
I guess so.
As our investigation begins, he was observed as he left. And do you recognize that woman?
Yeah, I think she's one of his co-workers.
Until they arrived at the airport, our operatives in South Texas were contacted. They were able to get to Dave's location as they entered their hotel. They change at the hotel, now dressed in bathing suits. They go to the beach. And there she seems to coerce him into the water.
Oh.
This is quality time.
Oh.
Well, that should be spent.
Oh, man.
After strolling,
he's about ready to cry.
They return back to the hotel. Their next location was the bar.
Yeah, they're partying up.
They grab a seat and have some drinks. We see them sharing an intimate
moment. Uh-oh.
I want
to see him. Oh, there he's still crying now.
All right, hang on, guys. Okay. Misty, it's going to be on. We know based on flight times that we expect him any time now. So what we need to do is go get the van and get ready, and I'll explain more once we get inside there, okay?
Okay.
Come with me. Yeah, we're rolling right now. Make sure everybody knows this plane is being taxied in. Nobody gets close until the plane's totally stopped, all right? Okay, there's a scar. The block is fine. All right, just wait. Okay, Misty, stare for me. When everything stops, when he gets out. You can't tell the truth on this side of the fence?
Just get me out of here. I'm gonna go home. Just get me out of here. We're leaving. I'm not leaving you here with her. We're leaving together.
Fine. Okay. Easy, easy. Give us some room. Did you know that he was married?
Yes.
So what was your rationale behind getting involved with a married man? Do you know he has a son?
They don't love each other.
Oh,
you've
really?
Been trying to get a divorce from her. They don't love each other. They're not meant to be together.
So you know that she doesn't love
well,
him.
Well, you might have understood him if you weren't pilled out all the time.
Okay, you see, now that's just uncalled for.
I don't think that.
Wow.
He's not having a broken back, you stupid bitch.
You know what she went through. Because what makes you think he's not going
to
bail on you
well,
when you have some issues? Because let me tell
you.
Even if I have personality, you can't depend on looks forever. Everything tied up.
Do you not understand? Get out of my face.
Okay. Now maybe we can have a conversation. Come on. Misty, come on.
You spend more time with that stupid queen than you do at home. You know, you came from a really good family. You showed me what family meant. All of a sudden, things aren't perfect anymore, and you're like, well, screw her, I'm gonna go find another chick to hang out with, and she can stay home with the baby, and then I'm almost better, because I didn't the only way you found people believe me, because it was so wonderful and trusting, and think so highly of their son, David. Believe me.
You're serious? Just walk away. You're gonna make me like you.
Are you happy in this relationship?
Not anymore.
Okay, no. Okay. What?
It's not my fault, stupid drunk driver hit me.
The Misty that I married died the moment you started taking more pills.
You try having a crack in the back, you stupid son of a bitch.
Then it should have been very easy for you to end the relationship. But yet you chose to start another one without telling your wife. Watch out, Jim. Watch out, guys. Why is your family still standing behind her? They've got it out loud. Maybe because they know that you're being irresponsible? Could that be it? Watch out, guys. Watch out.
You're trying to get out. Confrontation. A devastated Misty confirms she needs some time to sort out her problems. Ms. Love has since separated from her husband David. Her priorities now lay with her child, and for his sake, she's begun to wean herself off of prescription drugs. David claims he was never cheating, defending his actions by saying, when Misty stopped fulfilling her wifely duties, the marriage contract was nullified. Shortly after the confrontation, David moved in with his girlfriend, Courtney. David has hired a lawyer, plans on filing for divorce. Courtney Stone indicates that she knew what she was doing, and that her love for David has always been there, whether he was married or not.
If you suspect any relationship and would like Cheaters assistance, you may contact Cheaters by...
You ever notice these things are always... These things are always in the... like in Texas and stuff. I don't know why. Like they're always in Texas or Florida. I don't know why. Kind of weird.
Investigative services are free with your cooperation if your case is one that qualifies for inclusion in an episode of Cheaters. All investigators who provide services for Cheaters are licensed.
Oh man. I don't think they show that anymore, is it? I don't think so. I remember I used to watch it, but I don't think it's on anymore. Alright guys, that's my reaction. I didn't give you a reaction to that, but I haven't seen you in a long time. Alright, I'll talk to you later. Bye.